It may come as no surprise that the most frequent complaints a property manager receives are noise-related. All tenants have the right to enjoy quiet enjoyment of their rental property, but what this actually means can vary. Since there aren't specific laws addressing each type of noise, it's up to a lease to outline what is and isn't acceptable, like building quiet hours or guest policies. If these details aren't in the lease, then it's up to the landlord and tenant to come up with a solution. No one likes to deal with noisy neighbors. With experience in property management services, PMC has received all types of complaints related to noise, including
loud music or televisions, heavy walking, running, stomping or yelling, excessive noise after 10 p.m., noise from pets, children playing, running or yelling, as well as children crying, noise from gatherings around a property, noise from parties, noise from neighbors or others who are not tenants, alterations, repairs, and renovations in apartments. According to Vietnamese law, the Ministry of Environmental Resources has issued a national standard to regulate noise. It describes that the maximum noise level allowed in apartment buildings is 70 dBA from 6 a.m. to 9 p.m. and 55 dBA between 9 p.m. and 6 a.m. This means tenants should settle down and watch their noise after 9 p.m. If organizations or individuals in a residential area cause noise, there must be measures to restrict and minimize the noise, thus not disturbing the daily life of the community. If the noise level exceeds the permitted level, they can be fined under the law for more than 1 million Vietnamese dong.
Therefore, the best thing you can do is to keep this in mind from the very beginning of your search. Do you regularly go to bed early, need a quiet place to work, have small children, or are concerned about late night noise? Be sure to make that clear when you go to view an apartment. Oftentimes, leasing agents will know which buildings or areas are quieter or can offer advice on the best locations for you and your family.
After you move in, determine what's reasonable so you have something you can propose to your neighbor if you eventually need to speak to them. If there's a noise issue, talk to the offender directly. Stop by and speak to your neighbor about what's bothering you in a calm, friendly manner, and be sure to give specific examples so they can see where you're coming from. You could also speak to your leasing agent or property manager. If you've already talked to them and the problem persists, it's a good idea to start documenting it so you have something to show your property manager or leasing agent if you wish to make a more formal complaint. Take note of the noise problem, including the time, date, and any action you took. Additionally, there may be clauses within the lease or building regulations that allow for formal measures to be taken should the neighbor refuse to comply. You can then make this clause part of your lease agreement. Your building regulation should have specific times when quiet hours are to be in effect. For example, quiet hours could be from 10 p.m. to 6 a.m.
Remember, the property is for quiet enjoyment of all residents. Tenants should be respectful of their neighbors. Tenants should be able to enjoy their own unit, but should not do so in a way that disturbs the quiet enjoyment of others in the building.
There might be consequences if quiet hours are breached. The quiet hours lease clause should spell out the consequences if the tenant violates the quiet hours policy. For example, if a tenant violates the quiet hours policy several times, the tenant may have to pay a fine, or the landlord can file for an eviction. Here's an example of the sample quiet enjoyment lease clause. It states, quiet enjoyment. The tenant may live in and use the apartment without interference subject to this lease. The tenant may not disturb the quiet enjoyment of any other tenant in the building or surrounding neighbors. The tenant is responsible for adhering to the building's quiet hours. Quiet hours are from X time on weekdays and from X time on weekends. If the tenant violates the quiet hours policy on three separate documented occasions, the tenant is in violation of the lease agreement. The landlord reserves the right to charge the tenant a penalty of X dollars and or evict the tenant, the decision of which is the sole right of the landlord.
Further action could be taken. If a tenant is still being disturbed by noise and the landlord is unable to fix the situation, the landlord can decide to reduce rent for the affected tenant to prevent them from moving out. The landlord can also take measures to evict the tenant who is causing noise issues. If you're a landlord or a tenant in need of legal assistance to address a noise violation or an issue related to a lease or a noisy tenant, PMC Solicitor Services can offer legal help.